increasingly repressive CCP, frightened by its own lack of democratic legitimacy, works day and night to snuff out the lamp of freedom, especially religious freedom, on a horrifying scale. I spoke on this topic last year for a bit, and I paid special attention last year to the Uyghur Muslims of Xinjiang. But they're not the only victims. The Chinese Communist Party's battered every religious community in China, Protestant house churches, Tibetan Buddhists, Falun Gong devotees, and more. Nor, of course, have Catholics been spared this wave of repression. Catholic churches and shrines have been desecrated and destroyed. Catholic bishops, like Augustine, Shui Tai, have been imprisoned as if priests in Italy. And Catholic lay leaders in the human rights movement, not least in Hong Kong, have been arrested. Authorities order residents to replace pictures of Jesus with those of Chairman Mao and those of General Secretary Xi Jinping. All of these believers are the heirs of those Pope John Paul celebrated in his speech to the UN, those who had taken the risk of freedom, asking to be given a place in social, political, and economic life, which is commensurate with their dignity as free human beings.